The origins of the first human settlers in the Americas and their journey to occupy the two continents have puzzled archaeologists since the inception of the field. It has been commonly accepted that these early Americans crossed the now-submerged land bridge connecting Asia and the Americas. However, the true story of human settlement in the Americas has recently become way more intricate, with evidence suggesting a much earlier and more complex process. Today, we will look into the lives of the first people to reach the USA. How did they get here? And what evidence is changing our understanding of their journey? Join us on a voyage through time to discover the mysteries of prehistoric North America. Let's start with the Young Drus, a period that marked a major climate transition that occurred in North America between 13,000 and 15,000 years ago. This epoch, categorized by an abrupt return to glacial conditions, had a tremendous influence on the region's flora and wildlife. The early humans who lived in North America during this period had to endure very hard environmental conditions. This group of people, recognized for their unique stone implements found across the continent, is known as the Clovis civilization. One of the most widely recognized hypotheses as to how these early humans reached North America is by the Beringia land bridge concept. According to this notion, sea levels decreased during the last ice age, revealing a land bridge between Siberia and Alaska. But some academics are offering alternate explanations suggesting that this was not the only possible route. Archaeological findings along the Pacific shoreline are pointing to a probable nautical path named the coastal migration theory. It holds that early people migrated down the Pacific coast in boats, and it strongly questions the long-held belief in a single migration route. So, which explanation is most credible? Genetic data and the spread of early human artifacts back the Beringia land bridge idea. While the coastal migration theory is gaining support through archaeological discoveries along the Pacific shoreline. So the answer is both, maybe. Keep up with the most intriguing and heated debates in archaeology by following our channel. We gather all the cool discoveries that date back to our primitive past. Whether by land or water, the Clovis civilization, named after a site in Clovis, New Mexico, is widely regarded as the oldest recorded human presence in North America. They lived in many regions, including the Great Plains and the Southwest. They were adept hunters who relied on megafauna like mammoths and mastodons. These massive creatures offered not only food, but also materials for tools and clothes. Archaeological evidence, notably in the form of unusual shaped spear points, dates their existence to around 13,000 years ago. These tools, known as Clovis points, are discovered across North America, indicating a vast and highly mobile society. The spearhead-shaped tools, with their distinct fluted design, were very useful hunting equipment and came very handy in their daily life, where they could find themselves in dangerous scenarios. Predators like saber-toothed cats and dire wolves roamed these areas, offering considerable risks in addition to the problem of climate change. And when death came knocking, burial sites containing grave items suggest that people cared for their deceased and maybe believed in an afterlife. Evidence of art and burial traditions points to a community with profound spiritual beliefs. The events that led to their demise range from climate change to megafauna extinction, which could have significantly decreased their major food supplies. Some experts in the field think they adapted and absorbed into other rising societies, while others believe they suffered cataclysmic events that caused their downfall. But recent findings have called into question the long-held idea that the Clovis people were the earliest settlers of North America. For example, the White Sands footprints in New Mexico, found in 2021, give significant proof of human presence for over 20,000 years. The White Sands footprints provide a unique look into these early people's everyday lives, including their mobility patterns and interactions with the environment. The findings of the White Sands footprints has far-reaching consequences for our understanding of early human migration. If people were present in North America 20,000 years ago, it is possible that they adapted to Ice Age circumstances far sooner than previously assumed. This discovery calls into doubt the Clovis first paradigm and raises fresh issues about the early occupants' identities and ways of life. There are other sites that have challenged our understanding of early human settlement, such as Copper's Ferry in Idaho. Archaeologists discovered artifacts and animal bones that go back around 16,000 years. The items at the site, which include highly carved stone tools, date back many millennia before the Clovis civilization. This material acknowledges the coastal migration idea, implying that early humans may have gone down the Pacific coast rather than over the Beringia land bridge. The layout of Cooper's Ferry gives a vivid picture of how these early settlers lived. The presence of hearths, tool-making residue, and animal bones suggests a well-organized population with advanced survival methods. Radiocarbon dating of the site's contents has assisted archaeologists in developing a more precise date of human colonization in North America, further undermining the Beringia first idea. But it doesn't stop there. Researchers continue to investigate prehistoric North America using new methods. The ongoing study at White Sands and Cooper's Ferry includes diverse teams to analyze artifacts and environmental data using cutting-edge technologies. For example, ground-penetrating radar and other remote sensing technologies enable archaeologists to locate buried buildings and artifacts without disturbing the earth. Furthermore, advances in dating methods are giving more exact timings for human activities, assisting in clarifying the chronology of events in ancient North America. Researchers are now widening their search in other areas, including submerged coastal sites that were above sea level during the previous ice age. These underwater locations have enormous promise for revealing well-preserved traces of early human activities. Archaeologists are building a more complete and dynamic picture of how early people lived, traveled, and adapted to their surroundings by combining conventional excavation with contemporary techniques. These discoveries are altering the timeline of human settlement in North America, and their consequences are wide-ranging. They not only push back the time frame of human existence in North America, but they also imply that early human migration was more complicated than previously assumed. The coastal migration idea, which was formerly deemed fringe, is gaining momentum as more evidence emerges, altering our view of how and when people originally landed in the Americas. Previously, the Clovis first concept dominated discussions of early human habitation in North America. This idea proposed that the Clovis people, who arrived across the Beringia land bridge some 13,000 years ago, were the first to settle the continent. However, sites such as White Sands and Cooper's Ferry call into question this timescale by giving evidence of human activity thousands of years ago. The White Sands footprints, for example, indicate the human presence in North America when the last ice age still gripped the continent. These results are fundamentally changing our picture of early human migration. The coastal migration idea, which proposes that early people migrated along the Pacific coast in boats, is backed by findings of ancient coastal sites and underwater archaeology. This idea holds that maritime people may have traveled the shoreline using marine resources and eventually migrating inland. This concept not only broadens the potential migratory pathways, but also underlines the flexibility and ingenuity of these early people. The White Sands footprints provide a glimpse into everyday life during the Ice Age, revealing evidence of family groupings traveling across the landscape filled with now extinct megafauna. This provides a clear picture of how these early people interacted with their surroundings, sought food, and dealt with the obstacles of a harsh climate. Similarly, the artifacts and bones discovered at Cooper's Ferry indicate a sophisticated grasp of toolmaking and resource exploitation that predates the Clovis epoch. These discoveries have far-reaching consequences for understanding human evolution and migratory patterns worldwide. They show that early humans were capable of amazing adaptability and ingenuity, allowing them to survive in a variety of tough circumstances. This flexibility might have played a key role in the successful spread of people all over the world. Learn more about early human history by checking out our other videos that cover the lives of our ancient ancestors and recent primitive archaeological discoveries that are changing our understanding of our amazing past.